Hello, I'm Trevor Boucher from WFO Austin San Antonio. I'm the social media program lead here at the office. And as part of the series on social media data mining, I'm going to be covering Tweetdeck and how to use it as a situational awareness tool for data mining. Now, you may already have a Tweetdeck and use it regularly in your office, but just wanted to give an example of how we do it at our office that helps us for data mining, both during routine and non-routine weather events. Now, I'm not going to talk a whole lot about the features that TweetDeck has because you've already heard most of that in other lessons prior to this. But this is more of a methodology of how to maybe set this up in a way that you may or may not have already considered in the past. So a couple of things that you probably have seen before. We have multiple columns, and you probably do too. I have about 20 of these here. Starting from the left, everybody probably has their own content as a list that they're monitoring, so that you know the rest of the office knows what's been tweeted, you know what questions have been answered like this here, or anything like that. So obviously you need to have that probably at a base minimum. But over here on the next column is another one that probably everybody has: notifications, what's been tweeted to you, keep track of questions, comments, things like that. We don't have every notification type available turned on. Obviously, we don't want to be notified for every little thing that happens, every little like that comes our way. But we do have the two that would potentially be asking us a question, mentions and quoted tweets there. And then we also have sounds turned on for notifications so that the office can be aware of anything that comes our way. So those are pretty standard probably for all offices. Now, beginning on column three here, we have a special hashtag for our CWA for submitting reports. Now, this is shared through all of our spotter trainings and things like that. So this is fairly used heavily in our CWA. So during severe weather scenarios, we will get EWX spotter reports. So it's very important to have this front and center for monitoring when it comes to getting reports and getting quality LSRs. Now, starting over here on row 4 through 6, we have Twitter lists. Now, I won't talk about creating a list because you've probably seen that in a previous lesson, but we have our Twitter list set up here a little bit differently maybe than some others, where you can break a list down into maybe emergency managers or broadcasters or something like that. We've broken ours down into areas. So this actually mimics the Austin viewing area, the San Antonio broadcast viewing area, and then the Rio Grande Valley, which doesn't have a viewing area, but this is all the counties that are outside of those two on the right, and also have it's more rural in those locations, not as many as much population, so we grouped all those together as well. So pay attention to the titles here: Rio Grande Valley, Austin, Hill Country, and San Antonio, Victoria, because that is how we've titled these columns. So how we broke these lists down is that we, instead of it being, say, emergency manager or something like that, we've taken anything and anyone that would potentially be tweeting about the weather in these respective locations. So we have media here, we have San Antonio Fire, so fire departments, we have newspapers, we have utility companies, schools, even city organizations and city governments that we have followed in all of the counties that were color-coded in the previous picture you've seen. So that's how we've broken down the lists, and that's why we have these based off areas. So if we have a storm that is moving into the Austin area, we can take a look at this list here and then and try to find reports that we're looking for. If it's in the San Antonio area, we can go into the content, look for, say, any tweets that might be matching, say, rain. And so we'll pull out a tweet that mentions the word rain in it, for instance. So that's how we would extract information from our various lists. Now, our lists are pretty substantial in our first two, Austin, San Antonio, in Austin and in San Antonio, rather. You'll see like almost 200 members in that one. The Rio Grande doesn't have nearly as many because it's not as much, but we do also use this one as well. As you can see, we even have some information from what's going on over the border. So this can be really useful for breaking this into the different regions for obvious reasons. And then if you go a little bit farther to the right here, you'll see that we have our virtual operations support teams. So we have the Travis and Bayer counties that have community public service groups that are funneling reports and actually doing some tweeting themselves. So we have Bayer County severe weather and Travis County severe weather that we are monitoring. So it's important for us to keep track of them. And then also their public accounts, or their personal accounts, we keep a track of as well and make sure we know what they're tweeting and let them know if there's anything we need to address or anything like that. Over here in column 10, we have popular hashtags. Now every state has, as I'm sure you know, every state has a hashtag, usually it's hashtag whatever your state is, WX. So we're monitoring that. But we have a number of others that we've come over the years to find out that are somewhat helpful, like ATXWX. A lot of our broadcasters use that. SATWX in San Antonio. Texas fire is often used when we have fire situations going on. So we follow those hashtags as well as another means of following along. But then as we go farther to the right, we have these columns that are entitled ATXWX and SATWX and whatnot here. They're titled that way on purpose because they are geocoded searches. Now, in an earlier lesson, you had learned how to do a geocoded search. But what we did is we took that and we broke our whole CWA into these various regions here. We have six different regions, some smaller, some medium, and one large, where we've basically have 99% of our CWA covered in these geocoded search radiuses. Now, this only pulls about 25% of the amount of tweet activity from these areas, but that these are all with geocoding turned on. Now, this is helpful because this really helps us pin down where the information is coming from. If we find something in the Kerrville column, for instance, then we know that it's coming from this location here. And if there's any storms in this location, then we can keep track of, the reports that are coming from that location. So we have these broken down here. And in addition to that, we are looking at keywords. So the operator OR allows us to look for these terms, or wind, or windy, or any tweet that has any of these keywords in them. And this geocode syntax here, as you've learned in a previous lesson, this is how we do the actual geocoded searching. So we're constantly looking for these keywords, and you can add as many or as few as you'd like, but we now can have a constant search all the time. Now, most of this content will not be useful. It'll just be random tweets that, for instance, if they use the word fire, somebody might be saying like it's, just made a fire in my house, for instance. And that's not something we need to know. But occasionally, you might end up having really some good nuggets of information being extracted from here. Now, there's some caveats by doing these type of searches like this, one of which is that you'll sometimes find obscene pictures. You might see some profanity. That this is just Twitter in its rawest form, so keep that in mind when you're doing these searches. But but many times you'll end up finding some very useful information. In fact, just glancing at this on these columns, I'm actually seeing Ken's Five talking about a house fire. Now, if this was like a wildfire, this might be really something that we just pulled up right off the bat. So this can be really useful, and we often will drag the bar over to this area when we can't seem to find anything from the official sources, and we need to be diving into the general public and seeing their tweet activity. So that's why they're broken up into these various columns here, as again, they are broken into different tweet searches for our whole CWA. Now, the very last two columns here is scheduled tweets and then messages, direct messages sent directly to us. So those are far less used. So that's why they're on the far right here. But anytime that we don't get the content we're looking for in our lists that we have set up, which are usually a majority of what we get it from over here in these four columns, if we can't seem to find anything, we'll come over here and take a look at what the general public is tweeting and can really pull out some good nuggets for that. So if you have any, this is just one example of one way to do it here in our area. You can do it however you'd like to. If you have, for instance, DSS that's going on and you'd like to monitor a large outdoor event, in our area we have South by Southwest. So that's just hashtag SXSW. And we'll add a column for that. And you've already learned how to do added columns and doing searches and things like that. So this is how we would set it up for the majority of our situations. And we can always add more columns if we need to for different events. So That's pretty much all I have for this topic. I hope you check out some of our other data mining lessons in this series, and lots of really good content from various program leads throughout the country here. So if you have any questions, feel free to ask. Otherwise, happy data mining.